Power Yogis, Katrina Parr, E-R-Y-T. I'm super excited to share another yoga video with you this week to help you ground down, help you find some meditation that helps break you away from maybe some of the reality that you've had in the last 2 weeks. Today our meditation will be themed home. So I'm here, I'm actually at my home, I'm in my side yard. I know that all of you have been spending a lot of time in your homes too, so we'll go through a really nice meditation just to warm up and tune into the body. We'll go through some nice flowing poses and we'll open the heart and we'll find some expression poses to help you overcome some of the potential or likely confinement feelings or the feelings of the lack of movement in the last couple of weeks. So. Have a space similar to, if you're not outside like me, maybe find a space in your house that you have a little bit of room. I've got some yoga blocks today. I've got water, of course, and I've got a yoga strap. So have these types of things handy, just for the potential that we'll be using a couple props here and there throughout the practice. So thank you for joining me and watching this video. For those who are not in my Wednesday night in power yoga class and maybe a friend has given you this link, however you came upon this video, welcome. Empower Yogis, who I hang out with every Wednesday night, this is a continuation of the wellness themed 7-week session that we are doing right now. So the theme home, the theme of the meditating inward and identifying the reality of what home means is very much in line with that wellness mindset. As you know, I've been teaching yoga for 13 years, and I studied for 2 years to get my RYT, but I have never stopped learning. So actually last night, did some research and found that there's 5 Sanskrit words that mean home. And one of those words is actually shariram. And that means the home, the actual residence that you take in your body. So that's a really interesting concept, that when we think of home, sometimes we think of the structure that we sleep in every night. Maybe you're thinking about sanitizing doorknobs and light switches and things like that lately. But what the word home can really mean is actually this real estate, this vessel of like how you go out and express yourself in your life. This home is your body, where your mind and your soul reside. So this is your true residence here. So similarly to how you would pay attention to your house and how you likely have been paying attention to your house, pay that much awesome attention to your true home right here, your body. So we're gonna go into a meditation in just a moment. And before we do that, let's actually activate the pranayama ujjayi breath. So to do this, lifting the back area of the throat, the epiglottis, sip in the breath through your nose and draw that breath into your diaphragm below the rib cage. Feel that area below the rib cage inflate on your inhale and feel it exhale as you engage your abdominals and you deflate that diaphragm, pressing the breath back out through the back of the throat, keeping the epiglottis, keeping that back area of the throat lifted throughout this breath and throughout your meditation and even throughout your yoga practice today. And that hissing sound that you create when you breathe is actually triggering parasympathetic fibers in your lungs, allowing you to transfer relaxation hormones directly through your central nervous system. It's actually a really great way to relax yourself, an awesome way to be a vehicle for your meditation. So, eyes can close, activate that pranayama ujjayi breath, and just as much attention as you normally pay to the structure of your home, pay that much attention to your body. Start by sitting in a comfortable posture. If you haven't found that posture, locate that posture now. I'm sitting in a crossed leg pose. You might choose something similar. And once you feel comfortable, start to scan the body. Your body has a lot of things to tell you. Naturally, some of those awarenesses, some of the sensations that you feel first, are some of the sensations of discomfort. So maybe you're noticing some stress witness all of the sensations that your body presents to you right now. And once you've essentially taken a list of those housekeeping sensations, look a little further into the present moment of your body. Find areas of your body that feel free, that feel comfortable. Find an overall sense of happiness in your body. And we're scanning the body using that pranayama ujjayi breath as the vehicle to this meditation, and you're scanning the foundation of this pose, where the root of this pose meets the mat or the floor or the ground. Scanning all the way up through your torso, every individual vertebrae. Scanning all the way up to the crown of the head, the very rooftop of this pose. Continually scanning, using the pranayama ujjayi breath until you feel very aware of who you are right here in this present moment. And through all those sensations that you've cultivated, know that similarly to remodeling your structure of your home, you can make changes to your body. This will always be your permanent residence where you house your mind and soul. Use the ujjayi breath. Enjoy this wonderful present moment for one more deep, full inhale. And as you exhale completely, open your eyes. Take in the world around you. Witness how your body is part of the cultivation of the energy of this universe, and you are a major part, an awesome part of the world you're living in. Take in that really cool present moment. Let's open the eyes. Let's inhale and sweep the arms up. Let your palms touch above you. And exhale, just float the arms back down. Let's do that again, and on this time, as your arms rise on that deep inhale, let your palms touch above you, and then bring your palms to your heart. Feel the shoulders back, open your heart like you're blossoming your heart to the sky, and then as you exhale, interlace your fingers, reach them forward. Again, as you inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, floating the arms back down. Do that again, inhale, arms rise. Palms touch, exhale to your heart. Inhale, interlace your palms, reach them forward, rising up on that same exhale, inhale, and then exhale into angel wings. Cactus arms, whatever you call this pose. Peel the shoulders back, peel the elbows back, pressing the wrists and knuckles of your fingers back. Feel your heart open. Take a deep inhale, and as you exhale, let your palms touch in front of you. Maybe the elbows can touch. And then inhale again, angel wings, deep inhale. And exhale, let your palms touch. And once again, bring your palms to your heart, and now release your hands. Let's drop the jaw. Drop the jaw to your chest. Let the crown of the head feel heavy. Let's just roll the left ear to hover over the left shoulder. Take a deep inhale here. And now extend the right arm. Rotating at the wrist or elbow of that right arm. Sending that stretch all the way up the right arm, the right side of the neck. Take a deep inhale. And as you exhale, relax that right hand back to your knee. Roll your jaw back to your chest. Inhale again and exhale to the other side. So now the right ear hovers over the right shoulder. inhaling and sweeping that left arm out to the side, rotating at the wrist or elbow. Feeling the expression of that left arm. And this is an amazing counter pose if you've been spending a lot of time at your desk. And coming out of the pose, relax your left hand, roll your jaw back to your chest. Lift the crown of the head and peel your shoulders up with you. Peel them back and down behind you. Do it again. Explore the full range of motion for your shoulders, peeling your shoulders up to your ears, all the way back and down behind you. One more time, full range of motion for your shoulders. And releasing your shoulders back down. Let's move up into our tabletop pose. So place your hands below your shoulders, knees below your hips. And exhale as you round your spine, moving into Chakravakasana, rounding your spine, dropping the crown. Inhale as you arch your spine, opening your heart, gazing up. Exhaling, rounding. Let your own depth of your breath guide you through this sequence of poses. So you're exhaling every time you round, you're inhaling as you arch. Last one, let's come back to tabletop pose, Savasana. Walk your knees right next to each other on the mat. And we're gonna go into some contralateral movements just to wake up the core. So let's start with your left foot extending back. So extend that left foot all the way back. And right now you're still on both hands on the mat. Left foot lifts up off the mat and you're pointing that left big toe down. And right here, the isometric movements that you'll make is just tucking the hips under, firing up the low abdominals, drawing the navel in, drawing the rib cage in. You're really strong in your core, your hips are square, and you're internally rotating your upper thigh of that left leg so you can point your left big toe down. So you can stay right here if this feels like a really good challenge, like a really good pose for you. You're gonna keep the tailbone lengthened long. If you wanted to advance the pose, you'll just press the left hand into the mat and extend the right arm long. Find the extension, the full extension from that long right arm all the way back to your left heel pressing into an imaginary wall behind you. You're still really strong in the core, your hips are square. If this feels awesome, stay right here. If you want to advance, you can bend that left foot, bend the left knee rather, and sweep the right hand back and catch the top of that left foot. The beginning of a heart opening pose. You're going to get an amazing stretch for your pectorals. Keep your neck long, shoulders are still peeling far away from your ears. And if you're here in variation three with me, go ahead and lift that left foot just an inch higher. And then as you exhale, everyone release both, all four limbs back to the mat. And your knees are right next to each other on the mat. Step your right leg out long behind you. Lifting your right toes off the mat, keeping the big toe pointing down so you know you're holding on to an internal rotation for that right hip. Hips are tucked under, core engaged, tailbone long. You can stay right here. And actually your drishti is down to the mat. I'm looking at you guys, but your drishti is down at the mat. If you wanted to, you could plant that right hand and then reach long through your left arm. Very strong in your core, tailbone is staying long. You're activating that back right heel, right ankle. So you're pressing the heel into an imaginary wall behind you. Full length from your left arm to your right heel. If you wanted to advance, you bend that right knee, catch the top of the foot with your left hand. Enjoy a heart opening pose. Allow the pectorals to get a stretch. Stretch your quadricep. Hips are still square. Even if you're in variation three, you're still sending the tailbone down long. If you're in variation three with me, lift the heel, lifting that back right foot just an inch higher. And then release. Left hand, right knee back to the mat. Take a child's pose, take balasana. Knees out to the width of the mat. Hips over your heels, arms out long in front of you. Forehead meets the mat. Great. Take a drink of water. We're gonna come up into downward facing dog. Meet me in down dog. Let's plant the palms of your hands forward. Curl your toes under and lift up to down dog. So Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Arms are forward, shoulders are rolled up and away from your ears. You point the sit bones up high while you tuck the tailbone back down. If the heels don't reach the mat, that's fine. Even keep a small bend in your knees if you need to. Tailbone is tucking down while your sit bones are pointing up, so you have that compromise, that yin and yang of this pose where you're rounding your low back, but you're also arching to lift your sit bones, and that's your Mula Bandha, that's your energy of your lumbar, your deep core. Hold this pose for just another breath. And we're gonna go into a hip opener. So, let's plant the right foot. Let's lift the left leg high. Right foot is planted, maybe the heel meets the mat. Right leg is high, you can start to spin the right hip over your left, and then bend the left knee. So we're gonna go into belly of the dragon. I'm gonna show you variation three first, just because we're right here, and I will show you three variations. So if this feels too advanced, take the second or third modification. So those of you who practice Wednesday nights with me at the Wisconsin Athletic Club, we're moving into belly of the dragon. By peeling that hip open, you'll lift your left hand and you'll float that left foot down to the mat. And then here is where you have your left arm expressing your pose. You're gonna peel your left hip open so the belly floats up to the sky. Belly of the dragon. Variation two. If that looked crazy, try this variation instead. So you're gonna hover the opposite leg in. So here's your right knee hovering in. And then instead, you're gonna sweep the right foot out to the outside, the left side. And then you'll rotate on that back foot, and then peel, peel the hips high. And so now you're bending that back left foot. I'm sorry, back left leg. There's your variation two. Variation three, if all that looked like nonsense, you're gonna drop down to the right knee, sweep the right foot out to the outside, and you're just gonna reach that left arm up high, and here is your side plank, side vashisthasana. So, belly of the dragon, come out of the pose, meet me in three-legged dog, and then back to your downward facing dog. It's a great pose to open the chest, open the heart, express yourself through the arms, get full range of motion for the shoulders and hips. But it can be a little bit intimidating, so feel free to take that side plank variation. In fact, belly of the dragon is a variation of side plank, so no shame. Let's come back to downward facing dog. Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. And this time we're planting the left foot, reaching the right leg high. Get that hip open. Peeling your left hip, peeling the right hip over the left. Bend the right knee. If you're going into variation three, you'll just float that right foot down behind you, and you'll reach your right arm. Take a deep inhale. And again, if you're going into the other variation where it's a little bit easier for you to access, you'll hover in your left leg, slide the long straight left leg out to the right. You'll bend into the opposite leg, bending into that right knee, and you're reaching your arm. No shame in that Vashisthasana side plank either. Awesome modification. Meet me in downward facing dog, three-legged dog. And lengthen and lower that left leg. Shake your head no. Shake your head yes. So that is an amazing pose, but sometimes can leave your hands feeling or wrists feeling a little bit tired. So walk your feet forward on the mat. Come to the front of the mat. And we're going to come to standing. You're going to take your hands. You'll place them beneath your hamstrings, between your hamstrings and your gastrocnemius muscles. And it's actually the forearms, wrist to forearm. And this is your malasana. See if you can get the heels as close to the mat, if not on the mat, as possible. And just releasing the wrists. Placing a little bit of pressure on those wrists and forearms for a malasana, restorative pose. Good work. Come out of the pose. Notice how your wrists feel. Pretty awesome after that. They should at least. So have some blocks handy. Definitely drink some water. I'm going to give you a side plank or a side camel view. So we're going to go into camel pose. Have blocks handy just on the outsides of your heels, outsides of your feet. And then come on up to a fox pose, coming up to standing on your knees. Let's flow into Ustrasana, camel pose, a really great heart opening pose. Start by just inhaling and lifting your arms up high. And then giving yourself a tiny little back bend. Drop your tailbone really down long like it's tied to a cinder block. And then reaching your heart open up. Taking your hands down now. Bring your hands to your low back. So if you can, try to point the fingers up. The heel of the hand is on your sacrum, where your sacrum meets the top of your glutes. But that's crazy. Your hands can be just pointing fingers down. Really the aim is to get the fingertips to point up. And again, tailbone drops down long, shoulders peel up, your gaze is up. It's a really good back bend, but it's also a good work for your core. So keep your core strong. Keep your tailbone dropping down. Keep your abdominals engaged in. And let's lift the left arm. Lifting the left arm, see if you can just float that arm back, give it a full range of motion and come down to the block. Maybe the block on its highest orientation. Do the same with the other arm. Find your blocks. Really open up to the heart. If the blocks are unneeded, you can take your hands down to your heels. Your tailbone down long. Heart feels open. Take a deep inhale. And we're going to come out of the pose the way we got in. So lifting one of your arms long. Windmill that other arm up. And exhale into your balasana. Child's pose. Good work. Ustrasana camel pose. A great pose to open the heart. Keep yourself having an open spirit. So you're in balasana right now. Let's walk your hands forward. Let's flow up into your downward facing dog and meet down to the mat. So downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Shoulders rolled up and away from your ears. Exhale as you bring your body into plank pose. Hovering here in plank pose with me, take a deep inhale. And as you exhale, tuck your elbows into your rib cage, lengthen your tailbone down long, engage your core, and lower all the way down through Chaturanga Dandasana. Perfect. So here is your Sphinx pose. Find yourself in your, what feels like your frontal corpse, potentially. And just like in Bhujangasana, just like in your Cobra pose, you want to activate the legs. So very active legs. Your knees don't touch the mat. The knees are buoyantly lifted off of the mat because your legs are so active, but you can press your toenails, press the top of the feet into the mat. So we're moving into Sphinx pose. Separate your arms by the distance of your forearms, right? So measure that out and then place your arms out in front of you. Elbows tucked down into the mat. Again, super active legs, pressing the tops of your feet into the mat. And now that you've gotten into this pose, start to peel the shoulders back. You'll notice that really nice back bend for your low back. If it feels like you're compressing your low back, in fact, everyone should take a posture adjustment, just tuck the tailbone back down. Tucking that tailbone down as if you're like tucking the hips under, and you're holding Bhujangasana Sphinx pose. Press your elbows into the mat and isometrically peel them back towards you and then push them in, peeling your elbows in together. Like you can barely even tell that you're doing that movement because it's isometric, but just really active in the pulling back and pulling in of your elbows. Shoulders are still peeling back. Legs are still really active. Tucking your tailbone down long, really strong in your core. Sphinx pose. Really puff up your chest and take a deep inhale. And now let's go into your Jalandhara Bandha. So chest is really puffed up tall, and you just tuck your chin into your chest. So I can't talk when I do this pose. You're peeling your chest up, and you drop your jaw to your chest. And let's just take two breaths in your Sphinx pose, practicing your Jalandhara Bandha. That was awesome. Come out of this pose and let's move into frontal corpse. So stack your hands like a pillow and then internally rotate your feet so your toes point toward each other. And then just lie one cheek on your stacked hands. Let's take five breaths, and while we breathe here in frontal corpse, pay attention to your breath. Witness your breath inflating your diaphragm. Notice how your body lifts on your inhale and melts back down on your exhale. Listen and breathe fully into the depths of your lungs, practicing the muscles of respiration. Come out of that pose. Take your hands forward. We're going to move into Salambasana. So we're going to come into a few variations of a back bend here. So dropping your jaw to your mat. Let's inhale and lift your left hand and right leg. Left arm, right leg lifted. Take a deep inhale and lift just an inch higher. And exhale as you lower. Now the other side. Lifting the right arm and left leg. Take one more deep inhale. Lift just an inch higher. And then as you exhale, lower back down. So Superman pose. We're going to lift both arms and legs. All limbs lifting. Take another deep inhale and lift just an inch higher. And then as you exhale, lower back down. Stack your hands again, internally rotate your feet, so you're letting your lumbar spine neutralize, and relax the opposite cheek. that you did last time on your stacked hands. And again, breathing deep, exercising the muscles of respiration as you let your body rise up on your inhale and melt back down on your exhale. Take four more deep breaths. And then we're gonna come out of the pose. Plant the palms of your hands below the shoulders. Curl your toes under. And let's press up to your plank pose and back up to your downward facing dog. Walk your feet slowly up to the front of the mat. Feet are at hip distance. Take your hands to your shins and reach forward through the crown of the head. Here's your Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, Uttanasana, drop the crown of the head. Sink into your hips, lengthen your spine and rise all the way up to a standing pose. Let your palms touch above you. And exhale, Tadasana, mountain pose. Let's take a couple breaths here in Tadasana. Find yourself standing on both feet with your feet at least hip distance apart and parallel. Shoulders are peeling back. Move into Natarajasana, this is your dancer pose. So if you want to step off the mat or find a different footing, whatever it takes to find your balance, go for it. I'm gonna start by pressing the right foot into the mat. So right big toe, outer heel, baby toes, inner heel, filling the entire circumference of that right foot pressing down into the mat. And here's where you might use your strap. Start by drawing that strap behind you. Okay, so now we're standing in variation one, Natarajasana, dancer pose. If the strap, if you can tighten up on that strap, great. If the strap becomes unnecessary, you can actually just catch the bottom of the foot, catching that left hand on your top of your left foot and the thumb of your left hand on the bottom of your left foot. And here you are. No matter what variation you're in, variation one or two, you're going to square your hips, you're going to engage your core. That standing leg, that right leg is very strong. You can put a tiny bend in that right knee, and everyone can lift that right arm. And you can begin to bow forward, just a comfortable hip bend. It's different when you're outside because the floor is not flat. Finding Natarajasana. I hope you're having more success than I am with this pose. Natarajasana. Heart is open, core engaged. Tiny little bend in that right knee just to find a strengthened leg. Heart still feels open. You don't collapse into this pose. Take a deep inhale and exhale. Left foot comes back to the mat. Take a breath. Close your eyes even. This is your Samasthitihi, mountain pose. Now planting the left foot into the mat. If you're outside like me, find a place that doesn't have a big knot. Find a nice flat surface if you can. And then the four corners of your foot pressing down. So your left big toe, outer heel, baby toes spread like peacock feathers. Your inner heel presses down. If you're using the strap, you'll bring the strap underneath that left foot, the right foot, and allow that right knee to take a nice deep bend, enough for you to either take the strap behind your right shoulder or maybe catch the right foot with your right hand. An internal grasp of that right foot. Engage your core. Keep a strong standing leg. Hips are square. And if it's available, you just bow a little deeper into that left hip. Vajrasana. Oh, this is a very challenging. Very challenging on this flat surface. Enjoy the pose. Heart is open. And then coming out of the pose, float that right foot back down. Close your eyes. Stand in samasthitihi, so your feet are back to hip distance and parallel. Samasthitihi is Sanskrit for equal balance, so truly enjoy the luxury of standing on both feet right now. The luxury of having balance from your left to the right side. Balancing not just the body, but both hemispheres of your brain. Almost as if you could find that equilibrium, the place where your left and right halves of your body meet. Now let's take the palms of your hands to your heart center. And thank you for joining me for an outdoor empower yoga. This is not the end of our class. I'm going to move to the indoor of my house. So click the next link that I'm providing for you in the email. And we will see you for some restorative and reclined and relaxing poses. Thank you so much. Namaste.